that, which happens to be International Women's Day, and the theme for this year is better balance. But I'm not even going to get into those gender wars and all of that. Yes, I say gender wars. It's a complex situation. But I particularly love this day because, in case you do not know, FYI, I always celebrate my Scoop and Scoop anniversary with this day. Yes, the very first time that I hosted Scoop was on the 8th of March, 3 years ago. Damn. For 3 years, and we're still going strong. I can't wait for you people to know what I have in store for you this year. Ooh, we're going to make Scoop very engaging. We're going to have calls. We're going to, oh, let me not spill the beans. You'll find out whatever is going to be happening with your favorite show. But for now though, my name is Cinefius One, and before I can delve into anything, to all my mamas out there, to all my sisters, to all my mothers, to every single woman who is out there, happy International Women's Day. You are a bomb. You are what a terrorist should call a bomb. You are awesome. You're unequivocally blessed, talented, and all those things. I'm just here to make all the ladies feel fine. So yes, from me to you, happy Women's Day. For now though, let's do what women do the best, though men nowadays are superseding us. Let's get this tea, boo-boo. You see, on days like this is when I want to understand my fellow species. The woman. Now, apparently, okay, I was a bit in the know, but I didn't know how deep it had gone. Because, I mean, one, she was a friend. She is a friend, I'd like to say. But Munangi, like I tell you people, I don't have a friends and family package. So, later on, Bantu Dao, and then I finally read the entire Fiona Chirabo story. This amazing mama. Ooh. She was good with them brushes. She was really good with that makeup, with that beat. But one thing I think she is not good at, poverty. Brokenness, or better yet, a broke husband. Now, apparently, after Fiona and Mr. Chiovu, after they got married, apparently, like after 2 months, she was like, bye-bye. I thought there was money, but I'm not even laughing, but yo, it gave me perspective. Man, ladies, stop getting married for the wedding. Stop getting married for the dresses. Stop getting married for the nice photos on social. Stop getting married for all the wrong reasons. I mean, if you're gonna go before Christ and man and declare your undying, unquivering love for somebody, I'm prepared to sit that ish through. So should you. I mean, watch Musanyida Kumiti Majaba Saja. But then someone again hit me up and they were like, but you know what, Tina, that entire wedding, it was a planned situation. I'm like, what do you mean planned? They looked happy. She was happy. Until I noticed, like, a month before her wedding, she actually lost her engagement ring, and I'm like, girl, what happened to your ring? She's like, don't got it. And then here we are. They've been split for all this time. She relocated to Nigeria, closed all her makeup shops here. She has nothing here. I do hope she finds herself an ogao, because rumor coming in is she's found herself a new bae, a new boo. I mean, do you, boo-boo? Do you? I mean, you cannot hate on a woman for wanting what she wants. She's entitled. Na ye, give your bitch a yao, ladies. Before you want to get prestigious and begin telling all your friends in Zamuchara Gundo Mubuat, before you do all those things and just want to floss and tell people how you got it, you got a boo, you're booed up. So call bitunuli them and ask yourself, is this the person I want to spend my life with? Because let's face it, if you've been married more than twice, that's a track record. Every man is going to look at you like, girl, you're not J-Lo. Only J-Lo does that. She's been married, what, 5 times? Yeah, in Africa, I don't fly. But I wish Fiona the best, though. I do. Wherever you are, boo thing, holla at your girl. We're finna serve this tea. Obi nyumize. We'll talk. Oh, Jesus. So yesterday, roughly 24 hours into it, you know how I told you, Bad Black is taking pretty glow. She paid. She even put up the receipts just to let us know that what the right hand is giving, the left is seeing. Now 24 hours into that, she checked pretty glow in, and everything seemed like it was going according to plan. She had a balance of 2 million because the entire rehabbing system was going to charge her 10 mil. Guess what? Puliti gulo. Obanga ba amita puliti gulo. something like that. She ran away from rehab. Now, I have so many questions that I want to ask, but I don't think I'll have the time to get into it. First of all, what rehabilitation facility is this that needs to be sued? How do we bring you home? How? Even if they are able-bodied, they are still not... So how do you lose a person that I love for you? Anyway, she's disappeared. She's in the wind. MC Cats came and said some things about him. He's like, yeah, I lived with Pretty Glow some time back. And, you know, addicts are like that. So, wait a minute. All of y'all have known that she's been using. And not just regular using, like using. And now is when you all want to come out with your particular moments of high using. Like MC Cat, sit the fuck down. I'm sorry, boo-boo. These are things you should have said when the Let Radio Died. We all came out and were calling out people. I remember I was calling out anyone who was using or drinking too much in the celebrity industry. But you were quiet. Now, when she seems to be the one getting the hype, is when you remember to come and tell us, oh my goodness, I lived with her and she had a problem and you see addicts are like this. Well, let me tell you something. I'm not going to say that I don't believe in the rehabilitation system. It is a good system. Everybody needs to detoxify. Everybody needs to rehabilitate. But there's a quote I'm going to give you, and I live my life according to this quote. It's a creed. Addiction is the only prison with locks on the inside. Now, let me slow it down. Addiction is the only prison with the locks inside. Every other type of lock is outside, and you can figure out how to get into any room if the lock is outside. Now, it's different with addiction. The locks are inside you. Now, that's where I come and I'm like, I don't have nothing about the rehabilitation system, but I do know a thing or two about rehabilitating someone entirely. Because I feel rehab is more of a forced approach. You detoxify, go cold turkey, sweat, throw up, take meds and all of that. But I believe there's an easier approach to it, an approach that doesn't lead you back into the drugs that you were doing. And I feel what people like Pretty Glow need, it's not necessarily that type of rehab first. They need omuntamu kuwate kumukono. Let's sit this through together. Every time you get the urge, let's sit together. Tell me right now, I feel like I want to get high. Let me talk to you. Let me pipe you down. Let me give you reasons as to why you're not supposed to do this. Let me give you reasons as to why you shouldn't even bother doing it. Let me give you reasons that there's so many beautiful things about life that can get you high. Did you know you can just get high off scenery? Ooh, child, I wake up in the morning and there's a beautiful, perfect sunset and I'm high as a kite. On that sunset, you need someone who is going to be there with you and tell you it's okay, it's all right, I've been here too. You don't just need rehabilitation, you need a sponsor. Now, when you get yourself a sponsor, for all of you who have been to AA, you understand what they say by a sponsor. It is like a spiritual godfather in church. But that sponsor, you need someone who's going to pass you through it. Nemuba kwata, nemuba sulamu rehab. When they come back out here, they can't deal with life. They can't, because they've been sheltered in rehab. Now they're coming back to face real life and they're like, this is the reason why I started using in the first place. The rehab situation has brought it all back. How many times do you see them backsliding? Too many times. So this is all I'm going to say. For whoever wants to help Pretty Glow, I think this is the type of person who needs a minute-by-minute situation with them. They need a walk me through each situation. Rehab alone. How many artists have we seen go to rehab and they backslide? I think the only one who has actually managed to do it right is singer Napoleon. You remember I hosted him here? He was here yesterday and he was sober. He was living life. He was enjoying life. I'm like, you know, and that's because he opened the key from the inside, not the outside. Rehab, for me, is that lock on the outside. But if you want real results, you have to unlock the one inside. Mind, thinking, reflect, meditate, answer all the questions that you're scared about. All those things. Yo, some of us have a degree. We have like a PhD in walking people down the path of soberness, if we can. Of no drug abuse, if we can. Because we've been through it one too many times. But I do hope that Pretty Glow is found. And I don't know if they're going to refund Bad Black's money, because I mean, we all know 10 mil ain't a joke. And we all know how she gets that 10 mil. So that's going to be way too many ceilings, way too many thread counts, like way too many flights. Girl is pregnant. She can't take in all that type of man's, because it seems what? Every man will be like about one mil. Those are 10 men. Like, cut this girl some slack. Y'all know where she get her money from. Sad, really. Sad. But in other news, though, I want to find out how Cute Care is doing, and Cute Care would have been the best person to help Pretty Glow out. Now, it looks like two blind people leading each other, but they need each other to see purpose. They need each other to see the life that they created. They have a child together. So I'll suggest they are in the same spot, and so that they can be down and under together when they triumph. They're going to triumph together. Oh, well, I can't say I did medicine, but that's it. I'm just saying. Anywho, that's been my time on this here lovely Friday. Yes, I did not get to do the It's a Friday at the beginning. I've done it a bit now. Well, I have to leave you. Enjoy your day, ladies. And don't drink and drive. Wear protection if necessary. And what other motivation words can I come up with? I ain't got none. It's the weekend. I'm gonna turn up, but turn up responsibly. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Like, follow the pages on Instagram. It's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I'ma catch you again on Monday. Peace.